Get ready to witness the impossible. China is rewriting the rules of construction, breaking limits again and again with mega projects that leave engineers around the world speechless. Imagine this: massive dams generating record-breaking power, tunnels cutting through impossible terrain, and bridges so high it feels like walking in the sky. These projects aren't just massive, they're built at unbelievable speed. Highways, sea-crossing bridges, and high-speed rails rising in record time. But the real question is, how did China do it? What secrets lie behind these engineering miracles? The answer lies within the breathtaking mega projects that have reshaped our world. Let's begin with one of the most iconic of them all, the Three Gorges Dam, the largest hydropower project on Earth. Stretching 2.3 kilometers long and standing 181 meters tall, it consumed 28 million cubic meters of concrete and 460,000 tons of steel. It's not only the world's most powerful hydroelectric station, generating up to 118.8 billion kilowatt hours per year, but also a masterpiece of inland navigation, allowing 10,000-ton cargo ships to travel from Shanghai all the way to Chongqing. Its five-step ship lock and the world's largest ship lift have transformed the Yangtze River into a true golden waterway. But that's not all. Hidden within the heart of the dam lies one of China's most astonishing engineering marvels, the world's largest ship elevator. Standing 120 meters tall, this colossal steel structure works like an elevator for ships, capable of lifting vessels weighing up to 3,000 tons in just 40 minutes, a journey that used to take hours. It uses a counterweight balance system with over 100 cables and giant hydraulic mechanisms to ensure absolute precision and stability. For many engineers, this isn't just a transportation system, it's a symbol of how China dares to redefine what's possible. From the flow of the Yangtze to the rise of this monumental structure, the Three Gorges Dam represents more than power. It represents control, vision, and mastery over nature itself. But the true power of the Three Gorges Dam goes far beyond electricity and navigation. It stands as the ultimate flood defense for the entire Yangtze River Basin. During the monsoon season, it can precisely regulate massive flood surges, storing over 22.1 billion cubic meters of water in its reservoir, reducing the downstream flood peak and protecting hundreds of millions of people in major cities like Wuhan, Nanjing, and Shanghai. Over the past decade, it has successfully intercepted and released floodwaters multiple times, buying precious time for downstream regions to prepare and respond. This isn't just an engineering victory. It's a triumph of human intelligence over the forces of nature. If the Three Gorges Dam represents China's power to command nature, then in the heart of its capital, another miracle of speed was unfolding. Imagine the busiest traffic artery in a megacity, jammed day and night. Now imagine that the core bridge of that network suddenly became unsafe and had to be replaced. But there's a catch. The traffic can't stop. No months-long closure, no chaos. For most countries, that would be a logistical nightmare. But for Chinese engineers, it was a stage to perform a miracle. This was the San Yuan Bridge Replacement Project in Beijing. Carrying over 200,000 vehicles every day, the bridge had suffered severe fatigue and deformation over time. A conventional replacement would paralyze the city for months. So the engineers came up with a radical idea. Don't rebuild, just replace. At midnight on November 13, 2015, Beijing shut down the overpass. Then what followed was an engineering symphony of cranes, cutters, and precision machines. The old bridge was sliced into 27 giant segments, the heaviest weighing 139 tons, nearly the weight of two blue whales. Each piece had to be lifted with absolute precision. One wrong move, and the entire structure could collapse. It was like playing a high-stakes game of Jenga, suspended in midair. Meanwhile, the new bridge, already pre-assembled nearby, weighed a staggering 1,300 tons. How could they move such a massive structure and place it exactly on the old piers? The answer, China's self-developed Shentuo modular transporter. Each transporter had 96 wheels, capable of carrying extreme loads. Dozens of them moved in perfect synchronization, lifting, rolling, and positioning the new bridge with millimeter accuracy. Using GPS guidance and laser alignment, engineers ensured the final deviation was less than 1 millimeter. The result? The entire replacement was completed in just 43 hours, less than 2 days. A potential months-long traffic nightmare, solved through speed, innovation, and fearless precision. This wasn't just construction, it was a declaration. In China, impossible is only a matter of time. But this is still not the limit of China's speed. American Netizen, after seeing this, was completely shocked. He simply couldn't believe that China was able to build and put a bridge into use in just 43 hours. Because in the United States, building a simple bridge takes years. For example, a street light in front of my house burned out, and it took an electrician 5 months just to fix it. Seeing these complaints from overseas netizens, I can't help but laugh and cry at the same time. Even British academics were in awe of China's infrastructure speed. In one of his academic lectures, he remarked,
China has actually soared. It's meteoric. Former Czech president Václav Havel, I think, put it best. He said, all this has happened so fast, we haven't yet had time to be astonished. To remind myself how astonished I should be, I occasionally look out the window in my office in Cambridge at this bridge, which goes across the Charles River between the Kennedy School and Harvard Business School. In 2012, the state of Massachusetts said they were going to renovate this bridge. It would take 2 years. In 2014, they said it wasn't finished. In 2015, they said it would take one more year. In 2015, they said it's not finished. We're not going to tell you when it's going to be finished. Finally, last year, it was finished 3 times over budget.
The professor then talked about his trip to Beijing, where he drove past the famous Sanyuan Bridge.
Now, compare this to a similar bridge that I drove across last month in Beijing. It's called the Sanyuan Bridge. In 2015, the Chinese decided they wanted to renovate that bridge. It actually has twice as many lanes of traffic. How long did it take for them to complete the project? What do you bet? Take a guess. Take a look. The answer is 43 hours. Now, of course, that couldn't happen in New York.
After these words, cheers erupted throughout the room. The audience's faces were filled with disbelief, staring at the professor in awe, as if saying, this can't be real. This can't be real. The professor added that this was not just a triumph of technology, but also an organizational revolution. China has taken parallel engineering to the extreme design, prefabrication, and demolition all happening simultaneously, compressing time to its physical limits. He also pointed out why China has become so powerful today.
Okay, behind this speed and execution is a purpose-driven leader and a government that works. The most ambitious and most competent leader on the international stage today is China's President Xi Jinping. And he's made no secret about what he wants. As he said when he became president 6 years ago, his goal is to make China great again.
That's right. This wise British professor made a very valid point. The Chinese always approach things with incredible efficiency, never dragging their feet. While other countries are still debating bridge construction plans, Chinese engineers have already torn down the old bridge and built a new one. This is the essence of China speed. When all the braggarts around the world witness China's speed, every other pace seems as slow as a snail. China continues to create astonishing stories for the world. China's speed is the speed of global development. Wherever the Chinese go, construction and progress follow. This is what true global leadership looks like. Time and time again, the speed of China's infrastructure projects has shattered the world's understanding of what is possible. But this is still not the limit of China's speed. If replacing an entire bridge in just 43 hours sounds insane, then what you're about to see next will completely defy belief. Chinese engineers once built a fully functional, high-speed railway station in just 9 hours. It sounds impossible, yet it happened. The project took place in Longyan, Fujian, as part of a major railway upgrade. The goal was ambitious, to cut a 7-hour journey down to just 1.5 hours. So what was the secret? Modular prefabrication. Months before construction began, engineers mapped out every step like a chess game. They pre-assembled the track sections, sleepers, ballast, and even station platforms. Each component designed to fit together like giant Lego blocks. On the day of construction, 1,500 workers divided into multiple coordinated teams, removing old tracks, replacing switches, hoisting prefabricated segments, backfilling gravel, reconnecting power lines and signal systems, all moving in perfect synchronization. Laser-guided instruments ensured every track segment was aligned to millimeter precision. By dawn, the final weld was complete. The new station was live and ready for trains to run, all in just 9 hours. From midnight to morning, from old to new, this wasn't just speed. It was discipline, coordination, and engineering mastery on a national scale. a systemic miracle that only China's infrastructure machine could pull off. China's engineering marvel even made headlines in the UK, where a popular TV show sparked heated debates about the project while using it to roast their own country's notoriously inefficient railway system.
In the country, we're hearing these complaints about our transport structure.
On substandard train services. Just wondering, for the sake of argument, how the Chinese do these things. They were able to build a whole new station in the space of 9 hours by flooding it thousands of workers. We should be much more imaginative about getting infrastructure in instead of condemning people to being isolated in remote areas.
Was it 9 hours they built?
9 hours.
Sounds
look
like
it
a
up.
There is a
video here. You've got to watch this.
While British media were still amazed by China's speed, across the Atlantic, Americans were just as stunned. On a popular U.S. talk show, the host said,
"The problem, and they fix it. They build a dam. We debate what to rename it." That's why their airports look like this, and ours look like this. In San Francisco, it took 10 years just to get 2 bus lines through environmental review. The Big Dig, a tunnel in Boston, took 16 years. China once put up a 57-story skyscraper in 19 days. They demolished and rebuilt the San Yuan Bridge in Beijing in 43 hours. We binge watch. They binge build. When COVID hit Wuhan, the city built a quarantine center with 4,000 rooms in 10 days, and they barely had to use it because they quickly arrested the spread of the disease. They were back to throwing raves in swimming pools while we were stuck at home surfing the dark web for black market Charmin. We're not losing to China. We lost.
And that line captures the difference perfectly. Because in the U.S., a single bridge replacement or subway extension can take a decade or more. Meanwhile, China builds entire high-speed networks in the same time frame. When renowned British motoring expert Jeremy Clarkson first visited China, he was absolutely blown away by the country's infrastructure. Driving along China's highway bridges, he remarked,
"In 1988, China had no motorways at all. And now, 30 years later, it has 84,000 miles of them. That's more than any other country in the world. And they're only just getting into their stride. Since 2011, they've been building 6,000 miles of motorway every year. 6,000 miles a year! It beggars belief, and it's not like the terrain is easy.
Here, though, there ain't no mountain high enough, and there ain't no valley low enough to stop them. This bridge, for example, is 34 miles long. And then there's this one, the Douge Beipanjiang Bridge. You could fit the London Shard underneath it twice over.
I'm telling you, in Britain, we're doomed."
When it comes to bridge building technology, Britain simply can't compare to China. In the world of bridge engineering, there's a famous saying, for bridge construction, look to Europe and America before the 1970s, to Japan in the 1990s, and to China in the 21st century. Today, China's bridge construction has reached the world's top tier. Chinese bridges have become not only a shining postcard of China, but also an important symbol of its comprehensive national strength. Over half of the world's long-span bridges are built by Chinese engineers. In the rugged mountains of southwest China, a colossal steel dragon soars into the sky, linking the provinces of Guizhou and Yunnan. This is the Beipanjiang Bridge, once hailed as the world's highest bridge a title. The vertical distance from the bridge deck to the valley floor of the Beipanjiang Bridge reaches 565 meters, equivalent to 200 stories high. Building such a long-span bridge is no easy feat. The Beipanjiang Grand Canyon boasts treacherous terrain, complex geological conditions, and is subject to relentless winds, dense fog, and low temperatures. No one had ever thought it possible to construct a bridge in such an extreme environment. Yet Chinese engineers were not intimidated by these challenges. With ingenuity and courage, they overcame obstacle after obstacle. To build bridge piers on such steep cliffs, engineers invented the moving formwork system, assembling the piers section by section like building blocks. They also utilized smart concrete, a material that automatically adjusts its temperature to prevent cracking, ensuring the piers are both robust and durable. The two concrete main towers of this bridge stand majestically, with the tallest reaching 883 feet. Equivalent to the height of a 90-story building. The bridge deck is constructed from 22,000 tons of steel, with a total weight equal to that of 5 Titanic ships. The vertical distance from the valley floor to the bridge deck even surpasses the height of the New York World Trade Center, enough to fit an entire skyscraper. The total length of the bridge's steel cables reaches 250 miles, which, if stretched out, could extend from New York City all the way to Washington, D.C. The entire bridge spans the canyon, measuring about 1 mile in length, while the highest point of the tower peaks at 2,461 feet. The height from the valley floor to the tower's tip is greater than the combined height of 2 Eiffel Towers plus the Statue of Liberty. Such a scale of engineering and technical difficulty represents the pinnacle of human bridge-building history. This level of engineering and technical difficulty is not only a masterpiece in the history of bridge construction, but has also earned widespread international recognition. Even President Trump himself said publicly, "China's achievements in bridge construction are astonishing. They have accomplished projects we could never imagine, with incredible speed and quality. The United States needs to learn from China's determination." At the same time, U.S. President Trump also expressed his deep affection for China, emphasizing how much he loves the country.
"I love China. People say, oh, you don't like China. No, I love them. But their leaders are much smarter than our leaders. And we can't sustain ourselves with that. There's too much. It's like take the New England Patriots and Tom Brady and have them play your high school football team. That's the difference between China's leaders and our leaders. China, you go there now, roads, bridges, schools, you never saw anything like it. They have bridges that make the George Washington Bridge look like small potatoes. And they're all over the place."
The Beipanjiang Bridge began construction in October 2010 and officially opened to traffic in December 2016. Upon its completion, it immediately caused a global sensation. Major media outlets rushed to cover the story.
Well, a walk across a new bridge in China could send your heart racing because it's the world's highest, and it opened today. It stands more than 1,800 feet above the valley below, and that's more than a third of a mile. The bridge cuts the drive time between two southwest Chinese cities from 4 hours to just one.
John Davis, president of the American Society of Civil Engineers, admitted, "If this bridge were built in the United States, it would take at least 20 years. Yet Chinese engineers completed this epic super project in just 6 years. Such speed is extremely rare in the history of bridge construction. They even installed AI-powered monitoring systems on both sides of the canyon, constantly adjusting the tension of every single steel cable in real time." Think about that. An entire mountain-spanning bridge, fine-tuned by artificial intelligence. The sheer capability to execute such a massive engineering project. It's hard to believe China is still called a developing country. In fact, it's more advanced, more precise, and more ambitious than anything achieved by most developed nations. As the New York Times commented, China is redefining modern governance with Tesla-style innovation in the infrastructure sector. With each mega project built, China continues to overcome world-class engineering challenges through innovative techniques and advanced construction methods, earning it the moniker Infrastructure Maniac. Moreover, China has undertaken major projects in numerous other countries, each emblematic of its development drive. Behind China's global leadership in infrastructure lies not only a leap in technology, but also the support of a mighty nation. For over a century from the devastation at the founding of the People's Republic of China, it has been the successive struggles of generations of Chinese engineers that have painted the picture of today's prosperous China. And yet, this is not the end for China. In the future, China will continue to help more developing countries modernize, create new opportunities for development, and build a better, more livable world for all. Each bridge, every road, and every project connects cities and countrysides, the present and the future, China and the world. Chinese infrastructure has not only reshaped the face of China, but also exemplified the strength, spirit, and speed of the nation. The infrastructure maniac will never stop. What miracles do you think Chinese infrastructure will create in the next decade? Please share your thoughts in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. See you in the next video.